It's that time of year again. Valentine's Day is quickly approaching, and instead of gifting your loved one some sugar-laden, highly processed store-bought chocolates, why don't you just make your own? Not only is it much more meaningful, but it's much more delicious. Here at Candida Kitchen, I'm gonna show you how simple this can be. Let's get cooking. Welcome to Candida Kitchen, where we are cooking for a healthy and healing gut. And on this Valentine's Day special, I'm showing you how simple it is to make your own homemade chocolate. Now, how did I get to this point? When I was living in Japan for a very long time, I didn't know how to access sugar-free chocolate. They wouldn't ship it to me overseas, so I had to learn how to make my own. But now that I'm back in America, I actually have a lot more options. So if you're here in America too, this should be rather simple. So there are two ways for you to access this chocolate that you need. There are sugar-free chocolate bars and chocolate chips that you can use as your base. And that's the easiest thing to do because they're already sweetened, so you don't have to add extra sweetener, unless you want to. So today I'm gonna be using Lily's sugar-free chocolate because they are made with stevia and sugar alcohol erythritol. Here are my chocolate chips. The other option is buying solid, completely unsweetened cocoa mass and then adding your own sweetener to it. The way that we're going to melt our chocolate today is using a double boiler. Here I have water that is boiling. Just place that on top, and then we are going to slowly melt the chocolate. If you're finding that the consistency of the chocolate is a little bit too hard, you can add some coconut oil. This will help smooth this out. What you're going to need once the chocolate is melted is this silicone candy mold, or whatever chocolate mold that you might have lying around. I happen to have bought a diamond-shaped mold. Now, these chocolate molds are pretty shallow, so you can just fill these up with pure chocolate and have a solid mass. But if you're up for it, you can actually customize each bit of chocolate by adding some toppings of your choice. So I have some shredded coconut here. These are some chopped nuts. And I'm going to make some sweetened peanut butter because my absolute favorite combination is chocolate and peanut butter. So what I have here is just some peanut butter, a little bit of coconut oil. I'm going to add some vanilla. And a little bit of stevia. And then just pop this in the microwave. So it's all melted. And so when we pour the chocolate in, we can just pour that on top and mix it in with the chocolate. And whatever leftover chocolate you have, you can make a chocolate bar. Now that our chocolates are in the mold, all we have to do now is put them in the refrigerator to set for a couple hours. Once they're cooled and hard, you can pop them out of the silicone mold and put them in a beautiful little box as a gift for your loved one, or just for yourself. I hope you enjoyed cooking with me today at Candida Kitchen. If you like this recipe and this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe. You can also join my mailing list so you don't miss out on useful nutrition information at ilanahealth.com. Links are in the description. See you next time.